Make sure you watch to the end of this video so you can find out how you can win loads of free fishing stuff.
Fish on, fish on. Oh, right at the bank. And this is just ridiculous. Fish on, fish on, come on.
Now then, and welcome back to another episode of Adventure Fishing UK. Today, I am fishing an extremely overgrown stretch of river. This is gonna be great fun. There is huge nettles, huge thorns, all sorts I'm gonna have to navigate through today. I've only just dropped in on the first swim, and fortunately, it's not that bad here, but it will get very, very bad. Today, we are gonna be fishing for pike and chub on the river. We're gonna be using some top waters. We're gonna be using some sort of big shads and stuff. So I'll show you what we're using in a minute, but yeah, hopefully today we'll get onto some decent top water chub and maybe a nice pike if we're lucky. It's early in the morning. The weather's mild, overcast. Hopefully we'll catch some fish.
Well, what a beautiful morning for a bit of fishing. Even a beautiful morning for a bit of a riverside stroll, I think. Oh, days like these, eh? What are we gonna catch today?
So my top water setup for the day, we have the Rigged and Ready RR3000 on top of the LMAB Rod Father 5 to 15 gram. There we go, the star of the show, the Headbanger Spitfire. This is a smaller version, I think 11 centimeters. Pike love it, and I'm sure that the really big chub will love it too.
Right, first cast of the day, as I say, with the Headbanger Spitfire.
I absolutely adore the action on these Spitfires, and hopefully you'll see them working later on. But there's sort of that lip you just saw, vibrates in the water back and forth and creates a really sort of unpredictable action. Loads of wake, loads of attraction on the water. Setup number two, we've got the same reel, the Rigged and Ready RR3000 on top of the Predator in its 20 to 80 gram configuration. Great short rod for fishing places like overgrown rivers where, as you can see, there's gonna be a lot of bush to whack our way through. And down on the business end of things, we have the Headbanger Shad. This is a half soft, half hard bait with a paddle tail. And again, that unpredictable action lip. I absolutely love a paddle tail, as you're all well aware. So hopefully this is gonna swim a bit deeper in the water and we'll get some fish wherever they're feeding today. This is the deepest swim of the day, I think. So I wasn't really expecting anything off the top here, but thought I'd give it a go just in case. Plenty of other very top water friendly swims to go at though. And hopefully we'll be getting a bite on this. Oh, don't know what that was, but something just had a go at it. It's a good sign. Didn't look like a big fish. I think it was probably a chub. So this is what I mean when I say overgrown. I had to make this path down here last time I came. It's hardly even a path. I mean, this is just ridiculous. Oh my God, you know, my GoPro's on my chest and this vegetation is way above that. Bloody hell, this is bad. Hopefully there'll be a fish at the bottom of it though. Feel like I could do with a machete or something. Just chop my way through it all. Well, I finally got down here. And I'd say the chances of me slipping on my arse today are extremely high. I have seen a kingfisher though, so it's always a good omen. So nothing on the top water here, so I'm swapping over to the Headbanger Shad. Hopefully there's gonna be something down here and I've not just walked down all of this for nothing. This is
This is considerably harder on the way back up than it was on the way down. Whoa.
Well, today has been really tough so far. We did have that one inquiry on the top water, but nothing since. I've only got a few hours this morning. I've probably used about 2 of my 4 hours fishing, so not looking so good, but spirits are high. We're going to keep going and we're going to keep trying to catch either a decent chub or a pike.
1 eternity later.
Fish on, fish on. Oh, right at the bank, right at the bank. Oh, that's not a bad one either. That's not a bad pike at all. Right at the edge. Right, time to get down there and get this fish in the net, hopefully. And we've got it, come on.
Well, this is why you never stop fishing early. There you go, lovely pike. This has got to be a 7-pounder or something like that. Yeah, I was just about to call it, and then this has happened. Look at that for a fish on the headbanger shad. Let's get it back.
Well, there you go again. That's the headbanger that's just done the damage. Nice natural silvery pattern. Come on. Oh, I am so happy about that. Really wasn't expecting it. I was honestly thinking about just calling it a day early because I didn't think the fish were biting. But I'm glad I didn't now. I am getting blown all over the shop here. Whoa! Fishing somewhere so windy and so overgrown is an absolute challenge and a half. Love to see that it's sticky weed time of year too. Well, I am going to keep trying with this topwater even though the wind is outrageous. Just on the off chance, because I would love to see a blow up today. Other than that small fish we had before that had a go at it. Look at that. Nice little ladybird on the old net handle. So now we're moving back over some of the spots from the start because the water's a lot calmer, so I think I'm more likely to catch a chub over here. I'm happy now we've had the pike. Fish on. Fish on, come on. Now what do we have here? Doesn't feel as big as the last one. Oh, it's off. Oh no. Oh, a small part of me thinks that was a really big chub. Caught a glimpse of it, the way it was fighting. It didn't look very long, but it was pulling, digging deep on that as well. Well, that was extremely frustrating to not catch that fish. It felt like a very big chub. I don't know, though, it could have been a pike, but I saw it. It wasn't that long, so I really do think I've just lost a huge chub, but there's still plenty of time left in the day. If you are enjoying this video so far, please don't forget, hit that subscribe button, really helps me out. Make sure you don't miss the next video. Fish on. Oh no, it's come off. Oh no. How have I just lost 2 fish in a row? Oh well, I don't believe it. Another fish gone.
Well, I'm losing fish left, right and centre at the moment, aren't I? Oh, that's quite gutting to be honest. 2 in a row. At least we're getting bites though.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, it had that then. Come on, go again, please. Suppose that's top water fishing for you though. It was on for just that split second.
Well, that's all we got time for today, folks. It's a shame we did lose a few fish there, but we did catch, so I can't complain at that. Thank you very much for watching. Really appreciate it. Don't forget, hit that like button, drop a comment below. I also want to talk to you about a giveaway I'm going to be running very soon. So I'm actually going to drip feed information about the giveaway at the end of every video, or most videos. I'm going to try and add a certain item to the end of the giveaway. So today's addition to the giveaway is going to be a Rigged and Ready Predator rod, the same rod that I did just catch that pike on before. All you have to do to be in this giveaway when all the information's released is be subscribed to this channel, and also if you want to be in with a chance at winning the Rigged and Ready gear — there will be a lot of other gear — then you need to also be subscribed to their email list. So if you want to get a head start on that, head over to the website, stick your email address in, and there you'll also be able to see some regular content that I'm writing for their newsletter subscribers. I'll catch you down the road.